So in SHM, we know that velocity v is given by a omega cos omega t, because displacement is equal to a sin omega t. Now if I substitute this cos, if I convert this a omega cos omega t into sin terms, we know that cos theta is equal to root of 1 minus sin square theta. So if I substitute it, this is 1 minus sin square omega t, or a omega into square root of 1 minus, from the first equation sin omega t is y by a, so it is y square by a square, or if I take a square common LCM, so this becomes a square minus y square by a square. So take this a square outside, becomes a root of a square minus y square. Here I can cancel a and a. So remaining velocity is now given by omega into root of a square minus y square. So this is the velocity equation. If we know in terms of angular velocities and time, then we can use this relation, v is equal to a cos omega t. But if we know displacement, y is the displacement and a is the amplitude and omega is the angular velocity, then the equation becomes v is equal to omega into root of a square minus y square. So if we take the first equation, that is displacement, y is equal to a sin omega t. Now let us draw a graph. With omega t on the x-axis and displacement along the y-axis. Omega t is nothing but angular displacement. It's like theta. Put theta is equal to 0. Therefore, graph starts from origin. Now, theta is equal to 90 degree. Sin 90 is 1. So, sine curve reaches the maximum value at 90 degree. Again, decreases, becomes 0 at 180, and again increases and becomes 0. So this is the displacement and time graph. As the time increases, when the particle is in SHM, how the displacement changes. Now take the same thing and let us write velocity graph, velocity and omega t. V is equal to, we know that it is a omega cos omega t. Now put omega t 0, time 0. So cos 0 is 1. So graph starts from certain value. That is the maximum velocity. So at 90 degree, actually if I take this case, this is my 90 degree position. This is 0 degree. This is 180. And this is 270. And this is 360. Now same 90 degree, automatically it should become 0, cos 90 is 0, but 180 becomes maximum, and again 270, 0, 360 reaches maximum. So this is the variation of velocity with angle or time, angular displacement or time I can call. Now suppose if I take acceleration, now acceleration is taken on the y-axis and graph is plotted. Let us say acceleration equation minus a omega square sin omega t. So put omega t value 0, sin 0, 0, but this is minus sin. So this starts from origin, no doubt. Put 90, sin 90 is 1, but minus a omega square at 180 degree position, this should go to the other side. Here 180, 0, 90 positive side. Now if I take acceleration graph, 90 is negative side. Velocity is 0 here, acceleration is maximum but with negative sign. 180 degree, 0, 270 positive, and 360 negative. So this is the variation of acceleration. See, this is 90 degree case. These are all angles 90. This is 180, 270, 360. So from the graph itself we can observe, when the displacement is maximum, velocity is minimum. Acceleration is also maximum, but with the sign is negative. So displacement and acceleration both are in opposite direction. Now if you take the graph for energy, so let us take kinetic energy. We know that the energy equation Ke is equal to half m omega square a square cos square omega t. The kinetic energy, because velocity is omega cos omega t, half mv square. Half mv square means half m omega square a square cos omega square omega t. Now put omega t value 0, cos 0 is 1, so it should start at maximum value. For 0 degree, this is maximum. Cos 90, 0, so becomes 0. Cos 180 plus maximum value, so goes to the maximum at 180, and again 270 becomes 0 and maximum. There is no negative term because we are taking cos square, so you may get cos 180 minus 1, but it is cos square, so it is positive only. Therefore kinetic energy appears like this. If I take potential energy, so these are all variations, how the different physical quantities are going to vary. Now we know that potential energy is given by half m omega square a square sine square omega t. So sine 0, 0 starts from origin. 90 becomes maximum, 180, 0. Again 270, 360. So at the points where the kinetic energy is maximum, potential energy is minimum. Potential energy is maximum, kinetic energy is minimum. Suppose if I take total energy, half m omega square a square, because sine square omega t plus cos square omega t is 1. Therefore, if I consider the graph for a total energy, at every point total energy must remain constant. So you'll get a constant line, straight line, because total energy is constant at every point. So this is how the energies, velocities, acceleration, displacement varies in the case of simple harmonic motion. Here we consider the body moving along the circular path, and the angular displacements are measured from the center. So this is O. Body actually starts from this point A and is moving along the circle. So when a perpendicular is dropped onto the diameter, so as the body is moving along this side, we know that perpendicular moves along this side. So perpendicular is considered to be in SHM. So at any instant, if I join the center and this position, this angle theta, which is nothing but omega t, this is called phase angle. So with respect to the mean position, the position of the particle is to be mentioned in terms of this phase angle. Phase angle or phase just refers to the position of the particle with respect to the mean position. A is called the mean position because O is the center. Now suppose, instead of considering the particle starting from A, if I consider the particle starting from B, already it is making theta angle. Now from here, in time t, let us say particle moves to C. This is the time t in which particle moves to this position. So this angle omega t. Now the same displacement equation we can write as A sine omega t plus theta. This theta, the initial phase, is called epoch. Epoch is the initial phase. When t is equal to 0, the position is to be represented with this initial phase. So a sin omega t plus theta. Suppose if I consider the particle starting from this point, and now it is moving like this, then we will consider as omega t minus theta, that is the initial phase. So I can take either plus or minus omega t plus or minus theta, and the theta is called epoch, the initial phase. Phase always refers to the position of the particle with respect to the mean, with respect to the mean position where the particle is existing, that is going to be represented in terms of this phase or phase angle.